I'm Evan Klass. I'm the Executive Director of Project Echo Nevada, and I'm Senior Associate Dean of the Office of Statewide Initiatives at the University of Nevada Reno School of Medicine. Project Echo is a transformational approach to delivering subspecialty care to populations that have limited access. It started in 2004 at the University of New Mexico and was replicated at the University of Nevada Reno in 2012. Project Echo was conceived and initiated by Dr. Sanjeev Arora at the University of New Mexico. Dr. Arora's vision was to connect primary care providers with his team of liver disease specialists in an effort to treat patients with hepatitis C who were not able to access care. And it was that program that has formed the basis for Echo's replication around the world. Our team had an opportunity to visit the University of New Mexico in 2010 and to see Project Echo in action. It was a game changer. For the first time, we had a vision for how large numbers of Nevadans could access subspecialty care in an environment where subspecialty physicians were in very short supply. In Nevada, we were the fourth replication of Project Echo and launched our first clinics in 2012. In the 5 years since then, Echo has been replicated in over 150 sites around the world.
Replacement therapy certainly does not cause prostate cancer. But does it accelerate growth of prostate tissue, of all prostate, both normal and neoplastic? Maybe, but the evidence is pretty unimpressive. And, you know, I think that there was a suspicion that this would accelerate growth of prostate cancer. And I think there's very little actual data to support that. Having said that, in a man at midlife, I think you want to know the PSA before initiating therapy. And I think you want to perform a digital rectal exam.
When physicians are in short supply, traditional models of healthcare delivery begin to break down. If there are not enough physicians to see patients with a given condition, some patients are cared for and many are not. In order to provide broader access, some new model was required. Project Echo is that model. It's a force multiplier. It allows a small team of subspecialists to, working through primary care providers, have higher levels of care delivered to many more patients. It's not uncommon for patients who live in Elko, Nevada to drive 300 miles to Reno for care. That was my experience, and it was really the impetus for us to seek some alternative means of delivering care. Nevada is 110,000 square miles. We are both an incredibly rural and an incredibly urbanized state. Of our 2.8 million people, 2.5 million live in either Washoe County or Clark County, with about 10% of our population dispersed through our rural and frontier counties. In those rural and frontier counties, there are almost no subspecialists available. They're all concentrated within Reno and Las Vegas. Our Nevada State Office of Rural Health is unique amongst the states in that it actually lives within the University of Nevada Reno School of Medicine. In most states, the Office of Rural Health is a function of state government. Our Office of Rural Health has a very long track record of supporting innovation in healthcare delivery. Going back at least 20 years, our Office of Rural Health has been a key driver for expansion of broadband access to communities that lacked it. So from an early stage, they've been involved with healthcare innovation. When we presented Project Echo to the Office of Rural Health, they immediately grasped the importance of this for rural communities and were a key sponsor of our activities. In fact, they hosted all of our needs assessment programs, introduced us to community leaders, and were really integral to the success of the early phases of Project Echo in this state. We've had a very exciting couple of months in Project Echo Nevada. We have over the course of 5 years, slowly rolled out new clinics where need has existed and where faculty has been available. But in the past 2 months, we have launched 4 new clinics.
Only by empowering primary care providers can we ever hope to deliver enough care to all who need it.